Welcome everyone to yet another video, interesting video. This time we'll be solving or be looking at how we can actually convert fractions of numbers in base 10 to what? To base 2. Sometimes we have fraction. It can be a proper fraction or a mixed fraction in base 10. We can be asked to do or to convert such fractions to a number in base 2. How do we do that? That is exactly what this video will be highlighting or be explaining to us. So please, for you to benefit from this video, I encourage you to watch it from beginning to the end. Don't get tired. Okay, now let's go now. The question says, convert the following fractions in base 10 to what? To bicema. Bicema means what? To base 2. Okay, now we have the first one, 3 whole number, 7 over 8 in base 10. We expect to convert this to base 2. Then we have another 57 over 64 in base 10. We expect to convert this to what? To base 2. So how are we going to do that? Now we'll do this, so I write solution. Right solution. So we'll take the first two and A. 3 whole number, 7 over 8 in base 10. Now what do we do? Now you look at, remember when you are changing number from base 10 to base 2, remember this time how do we go? We go what? We go vertical. We go vertical. So this whole number part, that is exactly what we're going to do to it. We are going to handle it in that manner. So we are going to take 3 first. So write 3 like this. Okay, since I'm working in base 2, how many 2 do I have in 3 is 1, remainder 1. How many 2 do I have in 1 is 0, remainder 1. So for 3 in base 10 first, it's equals to what? 1, 1 in base 2. Now we now go down to the next one now. 7 over 8 in base 10. Now, 7 over 8 is the same thing as saying, this is it. Now, this is the trick that is involved here. You need to understand this. When you see this, you start, since this is 7, look at it. This is what? 8. Half of 8 is what? Is 4. Like what? 4 over 8 plus, you now go again. Half of 4 is what? Is 2 over what? Over 8. Please, always take note. Remember, by the time we add all the numerator, it should give us what? It should give us what? 7. However, while you are doing that, what you need to bear in mind, you need to work along with what? With the half of what? Of what you are having here. Okay, you go in half, half, half like that. Okay? Now, this was 4 plus 2 is what is 6. That means I left it what? 1 over 8. Now, look at this fraction. If I should add these fractions together, I'm going to get what? 7 over 8. Now, what will I do from here? This whole thing you are seeing here is the same thing as saying 4 here is what? Is 1. 4 in 8 is what? Is 2. Plus 2 here is what? Is 1. 2 in 8 is what? Is 4. Plus 1 over 8. Now let's continue from here. Now all this you are having here is the same thing as saying 1 times... No, let me not do that yet. So this is the same thing as saying 1 over 2 plus 1 over, this is what, 2 raised to the power of 2. You know, 2 raised to the power of 2 give me what? 4. That means 2 times 2. Plus 1 over 2 raised to the power of what? Of 3. 2 raised to the power of 3 will give me what? Will give me 8. That means 2 times 2 times 2. 2 times 2 is what? 4. 4 times 2 is what? Is 8. Now, all this you are having here is the same thing as saying 1 times, changing this now, applying our laws of indices here. This thing is saying 1 times 2 raised to the power of what? Minus 1 plus 1 times 2 raised to the power of minus 2 plus 1 times 2 raised to the power of what? Minus 3. That is it. So since I'm writing this in base 2 now, I'm changing it base 2. That means that my answer will not be what? Will not be what? Point this. Are you seeing this? This. 1, 1, 1. And I say, therefore, 7 over 8 in base 10 is equals to what? 1, 1, 1 in base what? In base 2. I can now say, therefore, 3 in base 10 plus 7 over 8 in base 10 is equals to, this one is what? Remember, I've done this to be what? 1, 1 in base 2. Okay? Now, this is point. Okay? You have to put your point. You know there's points there. Do you understand? So if I'm going to add them, I can try to do all this is what you take the first one for these three. 1, 1 points, 1, 1, 1 in base what? In base 2. And that is our what? Our answer. That is it. Not difficult at all. So for 3 in base 10 is what? Is 1, 1. That is what we have done here. We did that. And then for 7/8, that is it. 1, 1, 1 in base 2. So when you add them together now, okay, that will give us what? 1, 1 point what? 1, 1, 1 in base 2. So remember, what is the work here? The business here starts from this point. What we did from here. Again, look at the number you have here. This is 8. Half of 8 is what? Is 4. So you write 4/8. Now, with that now, you now start checking the 7. Okay, what do I have next? Half of 4 is what? Is 2. So you write 2/8. 4+2 is what? Is 6. Okay? The number I see was 7. What do I have? Again, half of 1 is 2 is what? Is 1. So when I add all this together, you're going to give me what? 7. You will understand better by the time we answer question number, that is the B part of the question. So let's go to B now. Now, B now, 57/64 in base 10. So what do we do? Remember what I said? Look at 64. Remember I said half of 8. So half of 64 is what? Is what? 32. So write 32/64 plus half of 32 is what? Is 16/64. As you are having it, remember, what you are having here should not be more than 57. Should not be more than 57. Okay? 32 plus 16 will still give me what? 48. So we are still in track. So let's check the next one again. Half of 8, 16 is what? 8 over what? Over 64. Aha. If I should add 8 to 48, what would that give me? If I should add 8 to 48, what would that give me? 8 plus 48, that would give me 56. That is 56. That means that I'm left with just what? 1 plus 1/64. So that is it. So by the time I add all these fractions together, I will get 57/64. I hope this is clear. If it's not clear, pause this video, rewind it, and watch it over and over again, and listen to what I just said here again, okay? It's very important. So what do you do from here? We reduce this. 32 divided by 64. 32 here is what? Is 1/2. Plus, this is what? 16 here is 1/2. How many 16 do I have in 64? Is what? Is 4. Plus, 8 here. 1. 8 in 64 is what? Is 8 plus 1/64. So what will I do? You know, I'm now at this stage now. So I'm going to do this now. Look at what I did here. Okay, so that's exactly what I'm going to do next now. So this equals to what? 1/ this was seen as a 2^1. Plus 1/ this thing as in 2^2 plus 1/2^3 plus 1/2^4. Don't make the mistake of saying 2^4. Because you say 2^4, it won't give you 8. 2^4 will be giving you what? 16. So 2^4 to give me what? 64. Because this is where we are now. 2^4 to give you what? 64. Of course, you agree with me that it's going to be what? 2^6. That should be 6. 2^6 will give me what? 64. Do you know how? Look at it here. 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 times 2. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 2 times 2 is 4. 4 times 2 is 8. 8 times 2 is 16. 16 times 2 is 32. 32 times 2 is what? 64. So that is it. So what do you do from here? So we're going to go over to this side now. So all this you are having here, changing this now in indices, it is said as a 1 times 2^-1 plus 1 times 2 raised to the power of minus 2 plus 1 times 2 raised to the power of minus 3 plus 1 times 2 raised to the power of minus 4. Okay? Now, this is the same thing as, now if you take note, oh sorry, raised to the power of minus 6. Raised to the power of what? Minus 6. Okay? Let me write this way. So this way I'm saying 1 times 2 raised to the power of minus 1 plus 1 times 2 raised to the power of minus 2 plus 1 times 2 raised to the power of minus 3 plus 1 times 2 raised to the power of minus 6. Good. 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 Now, what do we do from here? Now, if you look at this, take note, look at our power. Here's minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. Something is missing. Minus 4 is missing. Minus 5 is missing. Before we now get to what? To minus 6. That means that all this is the same thing as saying 1 times 2 raised to the power of minus 1 plus 1 times 2 raised to the power of minus 2 plus 1 times 2 raised to the power of minus 3 plus 1 times 2 raised to the power of 0 raised to the power of minus 4 plus 0 times 2 raised to the power of minus 5 plus 1 times 2 raised to the power of minus 6. Do you get that now? So that our power will be what? Complete. Minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, minus 6. But if you look at here, minus 4, minus 6, minus 4, minus 5, they are missing. So that is why we change them to 0, because 0 times all this you are seeing here is the same thing as what? As 0. In such a way that if I should add all this fraction, if I should add all this together, everything I'm having here, if I should add them together, it will see end up giving me what? 57 over what? 64. So please always watch out for that. Whenever you are solving and you find out that there is number missing there, that means you are going to replace them with what? With 0, like what we did here. Okay, so now the answer to this will now be what? 0.11001. So that is what? 0.11001. This is what? In base 2. That is in base 2. Okay, so can I say point is something like 0.? Can I say therefore 57 over 64 in base 10 is equal to 0.111001 in base 2, and that is our answer. So that is how we change, or that is how we convert fractions of numbers in base 10 to what? To base 2. That's how we convert fractions of number in base 10, where you have fractions like this, either a mixed fraction or a proper fraction. That's exactly what we expected to do. We can actually convert them from base 10 to what? To base 2, following this procedure. So please, I encourage you, for you to understand this very well, I encourage you to watch this video over and over again. I assure you, you will understand it, because it's actually very simple. Again, watch out for our next video, as we will now be explaining how we can convert decimals of number in base 10 now to base 2. How do we do that? Please watch out for that video. And again, if you have not subscribed to our channel, I encourage you to please subscribe to our channel and share our videos on all your social media platforms, okay? And don't forget to drop your comment in the comment section. Once again, thank you so much for always visiting Joshua Okuwe Online Maths. Bye-bye for now.